Hello dear students, today we will discuss the second part of the chapter The Summit Within from your book Honeydew. In the first part of the videos, we had discussed about the experiences of Major Ahluwalia, who had climbed Mount Everest, and he tells us that it was a mystical experience. It has brought a great change in him. Further, what he has to say about his climbing Mount Everest, let's discuss today. He says, looking back, I find that I have not yet fully explained why I climbed Everest. So he wants to say that whenever I think about those days when I had done this, I had achieved this success, it comes to my mind that perhaps I have not completely explained what was the reason of climbing Everest. It is like answering a question, why you breathe. It's like why you breathe. If someone asks you why you breathe, what would be the answer? We cannot answer. We have to say that we breathe only to live. Like, why do you help your neighbor? Like, why do you want to do good acts? There is no final answer possible. There may be many answers. So I am also not having a particular answer to this question if someone asks me why I climbed Mount Everest. And then there is the fact that Everest is not just a physical climb. The man who has been to mountain top becomes conscious in a special manner of his own smallness in this large universe. And then he says there is also a fact that Everest is not a physical climb only. Means physically we climb it, okay, that is good, but it has some other merits also. It has some other meanings also. What are those? Let's see. The man who has been to mountain top, the person who reaches the top of the mountain, he becomes conscious, he becomes aware in a special manner, in a special way. He gets this awareness of his own smallness in this large universe. Means when a person reaches the top of the mountain, he gets an awareness in a special way that he is a very small entity in this large universe. Means the universe is very large and a human being is very small. And this consciousness, this awareness comes to a man who has reached the top of the mountain, who has achieved the success. Only he can feel this. The physical conquest of a mountain is only one part of the achievement. There is more to it than that. So physical conquest means victory, achievement means reaching the top of the mountain, getting victorious physically. When your body, your physique reaches the top of the mountain, you are physically victorious. You achieve a physical conquest. And he says it is one part of the achievement, but there is more to it than that. There are many other things than the physical conquest. It is followed by a sense of fulfillment. When we have achieved it, we feel like we have a sense of fulfillment, as if we have fulfilled everything. It seems as if nothing remains empty there inside the spirit. There is satisfaction of a deep urge to rise above one's surroundings. There is the satisfaction of deep urge. Satisfaction, you know, there is a satisfaction of what? Of a deep urge. Urge is a strong desire. There is the satisfaction of a desire which has been achieved, which has been received, which has been satisfied, the desire. There is a satisfaction of a deep urge to rise above one's surrounding. Means the man rises above his own surroundings. He thinks as if he is different from others. He is totally above all the surrounding things, and he feels that satisfaction in him or herself. It is the eternal love for adventure in man, and it happens only due to the eternal love of man for the adventure. Every human being is having love for adventure. The experience is not merely physical. It is emotional, it is spiritual. So the experience is not merely physical, that our physique reaches the top of the mountain. Actually, it is all about our emotions which support us. It is about the elevation, rising of our spirit. Okay? He says, consider a typical climb. He says, let's take an example of any climb. Any typical climb means we have to reach the top of a mountain. Consider typical climb towards the summit on the last heights. Means we have to reach the peak of the mountain. We have to reach the last heights of the mountain. And what you are doing, you are sharing a rope with another climber. You are also having a companion with you when you are climbing the mountain through the ice and the rocks. So you are sharing a rope with that companion, another climber. You form in. Okay, you are totally devoted to your cause. And your companion, he cuts the steps in the hard ice. Means he is making path for you. He is cutting the steps. He is making the steps so that you can also climb after him. He cuts the steps in the hard ice. Then he belays. And you inch your way up. Belays means fixes a rope. Okay. He fixes a rope for you. So that you can also take a new step to go up. Okay, then he belays and you inch your way up. Okay, the climb is grim. Grim means disgusting, very gloomy, very cold. It is cold there. It is very disappointing. Okay, and you strain every nerve as you take every step. You have to strain every nerve. Okay, nerve means veins, nadiya. And strain means apply force or act upon. Means you have to apply force from all your nerves with each step, because it is very hard to climb there in the ice. And famous climbers have left records of help given by others. Famous climbers of the world, they have the record of the help they had taken from other climbers during their journey towards the summit, towards the top of the mountain. They have also recorded how they needed just that help. They have also shared their experiences. Recorded means they have written in their diaries as how much they needed that help at that time. Else they might have given up. Otherwise they would have left this journey and they would have come back. Now, breathing is difficult at that particular place. It becomes very difficult to breathe. Oxygen, quantity of oxygen is very low there in the heights. You curse yourself for having let yourself in for this. And at that time, means the person who is climbing, he starts cursing himself, he starts abusing himself, he is having criticism for himself. Why did he take this decision to climb that mountain? Why, for having let yourself in for this? Why did you engage yourself for this cause, for this work? Why did you take up this work? You start cursing there. You wonder why you ever undertook the ascent. Ascent means climb. At that time you are surprised that why did you take this decision to undertake this climb? Why do you want to climb the mountain? Such thoughts come to us. That is why he had said that it is not merely physical, but it is emotional. At that time, the emotions, they play with the climber. Okay, then what happens? There are moments, and he said there might come some moments when you feel like going back, and it would also come to your mind that I should get back. I should return. I should start my journey back to home. There are moments when you feel like going back. It would be sheer relief to go down. It comes to mind. Mind says that it will be sheer complete relief. It will be complete rest for you if you will go down, if you will get back. Instead of up, instead of going upward. But almost at once you snap out of that mood. But suddenly, what you do? You change your mood. Snap means break. You break that mood. You crack that mood. Okay? Of going down. And there is something in you that does not let you give up. And at that time, there is something in the climber that does not let him give up. Does not let him leave the cause, leave the work. And he is again ready to go up. Give up the... There is something in you that does not allow you to give up the struggle. Yes. We didn't want to leave that struggle. And you go on and you start your journey upward. Your companion keeps up with you. And your companion also keeps on struggling with you. Just another 50 feet or 100 maybe. In this way, we keep on encouraging each other that we have to take another 50 feet today. We have to take only 100 feet today. In this way, the destination is decided. You ask yourself, is there no end? At that time, it comes to mind. Is there no end to this journey? You look at your companion and he looks at you. You draw inspiration from each other. And at that time, you draw inspiration. Means each other inspire each other. We have to motivate each other. And then, without first being aware of it, you are at the summit. And then, in this way, putting all possible efforts, without getting aware of the fact, you reach the top of the mountain. You are at the summit. Looking around from the summit, you tell yourself that it was worthwhile. Worthwhile means good and important enough to spend effort. Means if you have spent, you have put efforts, then it is the important result that has brought to you. So it was worthwhile. Looking around, when you reach the top, the summit, and you look around from the summit, you tell yourself that it was good, it was important. Other silvery peaks appear through the clouds. Silvery peaks means mountain peaks which are there all around that mountain top, and which are silvery because they are covered with the ice. Okay, that is why they are shining like silver due to ice. So other silvery peaks appear through the clouds. You see those peaks through the clouds. If you are lucky, the sun may be on them. And you can also find sun there through the clouds. Because at the heights there are clouds. The surrounding peaks look like a jeweled necklace around the neck of your summit. It seems as if the surrounding peaks are like a necklace. And that necklace is around the neck of the summit on which you are standing, where you have reached. Below you see vast valleys sloping into distance. And below you, you see there are vast valleys sloping into the distance, downwards. It is an ennobling, enriching experience to just look down from the summit of a mountain. Ennobling, enriching. Ennobling means gifted with nobility or honor or grace. So it is a novel experience. It is an enriching experience. Enriching means enhancing, making rich. Means it enhances your knowledge. It raises your spirit. Okay. So it is an ennobling, enriching experience to just look down from the summit of a mountain. Means when you are standing at the top of the mountain, summit of the mountain, peak of the mountain, and when you see, look down, then that experience is very new, very novel for you, and that is very graceful experience for you, enriching experience for you. You bow down, and when you bow down means to bend oneself as a gesture of respect. At that time, you bow down and make your obeisance to whichever God you worship. Okay, so make your obeisance means show your obedience or submission. So there, when you reach there, it is an ennobling experience, it is enriching experience. And when you look down, it happens when you look down the summit of the mountain, and then you bow down there and make your obeisance, mean you make your obedience to the God whichever you worship. Here, should we stop for today? It will be very long video. Anyways, let's discuss one more paragraph passage. Okay, he says, I left on Everest a picture of Guru Nanak. So when you bow down and you show your respect to your gods, so we did that too. And he says, I left on Everest a picture of Guru Nanak. Guru Nanak Dev, first Guru of Sikhs, I left the picture of Guru Nanak Dev there. Rawat, his companion, left a picture of Goddess Durga. Fudorji left a relic of Buddha. A relic is an ancient religious object. Any ancient religious object. In other words, dear students, in Hindi it is also called Nishani. Guru Devataon ki Nishani. Buddha ki koi Nishani. Fudorji left a relic of Buddha. Edmund Hillary had buried a cross under the cairn. Cairn is a heap of rocks and stones in the snow. These are not symbols of conquest, but of reverence. Reverence means respect, obedience. Okay, so these were not symbols of conquest. These were merely a part of symbols of reverence. Okay, so here we would stop for today. The words here used are a little difficult and new for you, and there are many new terms and ideologies given. Try to read and understand. When you will read, you have to understand everything. If you find any problem, you may make a call to me. In the next and last video, we will be discussing the rest part of this chapter as well as the exercise part of this chapter. Okay, so till then, you keep reading, keep doing your work, stay happy. Stay good. Thank you. Thank you very much.